physical change. Children, you know that there are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas, fire, water, fruits, vegetables. Vehicles are all matter. Matter takes up space and is present everywhere. Matter goes through either physical or chemical changes. In this video, we will learn about physical changes. Let us go to a village in Bihar to understand this subject better. Let us meet Rama and Babu to understand this topic better.
Rama, Rama, please switch off the stove. The water has been boiling for long. I had to prepare tea for father.
Mother, there is no water in this vessel. Looks like water boiled for a long time. I shall add more water to boil. We need to prepare tea for father.
Oh, yes, Didi. Where has the water gone? Will you please explain where the water disappeared?
Babu, come here and sit down. I will explain this to you. Water had evaporated and mixed with the atmosphere.
I will give you an example. Due to the heat of the sun, water from ponds, rivers, oceans, etc. evaporates and forms clouds. Due to the wind,
water vapors rise up in the air and forms clouds. These clouds become heavy due to droplets of water and fall down as rain.
Okay, how does all this happen?
Come here, I will explain in detail. I will get a cube of ice.
Children, let us perform an experiment. You take a piece of chalk and powder it. Then collect the whole powder. Add some water and roll it out in the form of a chalk and let it dry. Can you get the whole chalk piece back?
Didi, what will you do with this ice cube? It is melting. It will become water.
Yes, you are right. This ice will melt and become water. This is called physical change. If you freeze this water again, it will become ice.
Does this mean that this change can be reversed?
Yes, you are right. Physical change is reversible.
When the water was completely boiled, some time ago, it became steam. If we put a lid on that vessel, water vapors cool down to form water droplets, and then steam will become water again.
This is interesting. Are there any other physical changes that we witness in our daily life?
Yes, yes. You know, no new substance is formed in physical change. Water is formed when ice melts and water becomes vapor when it is heated.
Can you give me another example of such a change?
Let me think.
Remember that in physical changes, there can be a change in color, shape and state of the substance.
Yes, I know. When we knead the dough and make a dough ball, it is a physical change. Then, when we make the roti with the dough ball, that is also a physical change.
Rightly said. Uncooked roti is an example of a physical change. If we do not need the uncooked roti, we can make the uncooked roti into a dough ball again. What happens by dissolving a little ground sugar in water?
It dissolves. This is a physical change. Nothing new is formed from this.
If the paper tears into many parts, the change happens. But there is no change in the mass. If all torn pieces are combined, they will have the same mass as the original paper. Many mixtures are examples of physical change.
Mixing water and sand is an example of physical change. Isn't it, Didi? These two can be separated into water and sand again.
Hey, wow! You have understood it quickly. Physical changes are mostly temporary. This is how we see physical changes every day.
Didi, shall I tell you something funny? When my hair grows, I go to the hairdresser and get my hair cut. This is also a physical change. My hair becomes short and over a period of time, hair grows back.
Well said. Let's go and play now.
Children, today we learnt about physical changes. Chopping wood, mixing colored stones, making of ice, chopping an apple, mixing water and sand are many examples of physical changes. We will learn about chemical changes in the next video. See you soon.